This is how to start your replacement phone and transfer everything from your old phone to the new replacement phone. This is using the Samsung Galaxy S21 5G. This is my old one, and this is the replacement one. The first thing to do when you receive your replacement phone is put it on the charger, because the ones I've gotten always come stone dead. So make sure to put it on the charger and get a healthy charge and leave a cord plugged into it. The other thing you want to do if you haven't already is go to settings on your old phone, go down here to accounts and backup, backup data, and the Samsung cloud. Go here and backup now. Now I've already done that, so I'm not going to do it, but you hit backup now and then back out of it and you'll be good. That's just a precaution. What we're actually going to do is just transfer everything directly from the phone to the new phone. The first thing we do is go into the box, charging cord, we have a new SIM card that we won't need because we have our old phone, and we have the key for removing the old SIM card. So I'm going to make sure both phones are off. Off as well. This particular phone has a case, so you want to take the case off. And I have the same phone for the replacement, so I'll be able to use that again. I'll just put that off to the side. This cover is probably needs to be replaced. I've already ordered a new set. I tried reapplying it before on a different phone and it didn't work that well. Now that the phone is exposed, what we can see is right here, we're going to take this key and we're going to stick it in this hole. And it should spring up. There we go. Springs up this little tray for the SIM card. Okay. Now we're going to do the same thing on the new phone. I'm going to unplug it for a second here. Okay, there's that. Now, I don't really want to touch, if I can avoid it, put this thing back in here. And now you have the copper tracing on the top. You can see the little notch right there. And you can also see a notch right there, as well as on the little picture. So I'm going to pick that up in here, make sure that it's flush in there. Stick it in. Oops. Don't force it, make sure it's in there clean. Okay, it's smooth. All right, so that's the first step. Now I'm gonna leave the film and protectors on this one so that I know that's my new one. You don't wanna get confused and accidentally use the wrong phone. So let's turn that one on. Okay, and it's going to come up. You're going to start it. I'm here in the States, so I'm in English. Agree to all. More. Agree. Here we go. Choose a Wi-Fi network. All right, auto reconnect. Connect. Next. All right, now I gotta go back through Google. So, unfortunately, Google is set up to do this two-step verification thing. Yes, it's me. Okay. Yes, I'm in. I agree. Store data from another device. Yes. So I'm going to take it from that one. All right. Choose what to restore. I'm going to restore all of it. Restore. And I want to confirm the pin without tapping OK. Fine, fine. All right. Okay. Accept. Bring your old data for quick setup. Next. Smart Switch is the program that Samsung uses to transfer data from the old phone to the new phone. Okay, get started with Smart Switch. Select a source. What's your old device? It's a Galaxy. I'm not going to use the cable, and this was especially important in the previous one because the reason my original phone was being submitted for warranty or for insurance was because it had a permanent water signal and wouldn't allow a cord to be connected. So even if you have that issue, you can still connect it wireless. Let me go over here. Smart Switch wants us to take a picture. Open. I'm going to send it data from this phone wirelessly. I'm going to say OK here. Connect. All right. Now what's happening is Smart Switch is being used to take everything off of this onto here. So when you change the SIM card from here to here, it takes the phone number and some of the basics with it, but then this is taking all the other data. So photos, music, all this stuff. And I want everything. Now, this threw up a little deal here. Did you just sign in? Yes. Keep the screen on to make sure it's working. It says you're all set up. Finish. Okay, and you can see that now my background looks just like the old phone. However, not everything is exactly like I wanted it, but, ooh, Porsche, nice. What you can see is it's in the transferring process, and it says there's 40 minutes left. So basically what happens from now on is you're going to go through this transferring of everything, and then at some point it's going to get into a mode where it'll say setting up or whatever. 3:07 now. We'll check back in later. You can see that the program is organizing the transfer data. So that means that you're all done transferring from this one. That's done. Okay. But I always wait till this is completely done before I go wipe that off to send it back. You still have Wi-Fi even though you don't have cell signal, so you still do get things like emails and whatever else. All right, it's not been quite an hour. Now you see it does look exactly like my old phone, which is great. Next comes the painful part. Now you have to go into everything from email to whatever
and you have to set up with all your passwords again. So even though all the apps come over, which is great, so you have to go through setting up every single app and logging in again. You just have to do it once in theory, starting off, but you have to go through every app again. Now this I'm having to do in my Samsung account because I'm saving that password in here. Now I have to set up the scanning with my fingertip. So this is just a process you have to keep putting down, picking it up. And there we go, that's done. So now my fingerprint is added to this for biometric access to all my passwords. But again, everything you've got, Instagram, whatever, Facebook, anything, you're gonna have to go through and enter in your password for every one of these again. But once you get through that, strongly recommend as soon as you get this, check everything out. Make sure Bluetooth to everything you're used to using it works. Make sure all your apps work properly, etc. Because in my case, I didn't find out till I'd spent all this time that it actually was not connecting to Bluetooth and staying that way and had to send, you know, so I'm repeating all this that I just did 2 days ago. Once you've confirmed the new phone is working sufficiently, and the last step of the process is to wipe your old phone clean before you send it back in. You want to get rid of all your personal information from financial, login, passwords, and incriminating texts and photos. To do that, we're going to start by pulling down the settings, and we're going to go to General Management, Reset. We're going to Factory Data Reset. So make sure everything you want is on your other phone, because once I hit this button, go through all this, it's gone. Delete all. Samsung account. What? And it says it's erasing. Welcome, start. Okay. So this means you're all the way out. Insert a SIM card. I'm just going to get far enough. I want to get far enough just to see the skip anyway. Fine. Skip anyway. What I really want to see is that this is back to nothing. There's no texts. There's no pictures. There's nothing on this thing. Contacts, nothing. So everything's gone, okay? Easy enough. Now just power it off. Then put it back in the box. Back the way it was. The box has some foam packing. I'm going to leave that there. There's the labeling sticker. And there's the piece of tape. Oops. And there's the piece of tape to reseal your box. I put the phone in here. The foam in there. Put this in. This tape can be kind of a pain to get the corner started. Finally, okay, there's that side of it. That, put the sticker over the old label so it doesn't end up back on your doorstep. And now it's ready to just drop off in a UPS store.
Subscribe to my YouTube channel below and let's celebrate turning fuel and air into adrenaline!